Hi mommies and daddies, today I'm going to present word games that you can play with your children of any age group. These games would improve your child's literacy skills, specifically their spellings, vocabulary, reading and writing skills. These games can be played by any age group of child, so you can vary the level of difficulty as per the child's age. So without any further ado, let's get started. Welcome to Pyle's Life Coaching, number one place for parents of kids aged 0 to 10 years who wants to be happy within, who wants to have happy relationship with their spouse and want to raise happy kids and thus have happy families. If you wish to be one, then let's grow together. Number one is word association game. Number of players, more than two. In this game, one player says a word and the next player has to say a related word to the word being said. If it is not related, not linked, then that person gets out of the game. In this game, generally people tend to think ahead and they link up with the previous player. And that's where they generally lose and get out of the game easily. So this game improves child's listening skills, attention, concentration and also improves the vocabulary.
Corona.
Virus.
America.
Surat.
China.
Mask.
Mask. Soap.
Wash.
Sanitizer.
Out. So you're out. Now between you and me, and now we will start a new game.
Okay.
You say a word.
You ready for it? Oh,
no,
just
she's
both of them. Doctor.
Nurse.
Paramedical.
Medical.
Ambulance.
Number two is Hangman. Probably one of the most famous word game for kids is Hangman. This game improves children's spellings. Number of players required, two. And material required, pen and paper. In this game, one player thinks of a spelling and the other player has to guess it before they get hung. How it is played? Let's say it. Player 1 writes spaces for letters on the page so that player 2 know how many letters are there in the word. Player 2 proceeds to choose a letter they think may be in the word. If it is correct, player 1 writes the letter down where it goes. If it is incorrect, player 1 draws part of the hangman. If the drawing is complete by the time player 2 guesses, then player 1 wins. Next game is Word Chain. In this game, we need more than 2 players. Material required is nothing. One person says a word, say apple. The second person has to add another word to it, say tasty. So apple, tasty. Third player says another word added to this chain. Say maybe apple, tasty, orange. And this way each person keeps on adding a word, but at the same time they have to remember the words being already said. If any person misses a word, that person is out of the game and the new chain starts. So this game improves the child's listening skills, attention and retention.
India.
Australia. India, Australia.
India, Australia, Pakistan.
India, Australia, Pakistan, China.
India, Australia, Pakistan, China, England.
India, Australia, Pakistan, China, England, Nepal.
India, Australia, Pakistan, China, England, Nepal, and Bangladesh.
India, Australia, China.
Out. Next game is Who Am I? Again, in this game, we need more than 2 players and no material is required. This game improves thinking skills and question making. One player thinks of any celebrity or a common person known to the family or an animal. The other players have to guess that whom he is thinking about. And they have to ask questions to know that. Make sure that children or any player ask specifically proper questions so that their question making is improved. Take a look. I'm thinking of a celebrity and you have to ask me questions to guess that whom I'm thinking about. Okay.
It's a male or a female?
Wrong question. Ask properly, otherwise I will not answer you.
Is it a male or a female?
Female.
A Bollywood actress?
Ask
me. Is it a Bollywood actress?
No.
Then she must be a politician?
Ask me question. I will answer only
questions. Is she a politician?
No.
Then is she a sports person?
Yes.
Okay. Does she play tennis?
Yes, even let her speak, no?
What?
Yes, come on.
I don't know any
tennis player. An Indian tennis player. Is she an Indian tennis player?
Yes.
Come on, Kushi. She did come in Kapil Sharma show, remember?
Oh, I can't remember the name, but I remember
her. She's married to a Pakistani cricketer?
Ask me in a question form.
Is she married to a Pakistani cricketer?
Yes.
Come on, Khushi.
Now you know. You can answer.
I want you to give
you
it a
it.
Chance.
I mean, you can say.
She is Sania Mirza.
Yes, I will got the name. I am going to think about an animal, and you need to guess that which animal it is.
Okay. Does it roar?
Roar.
Roar.
Nope.
Okay.
Does it bark?
Nope.
Is it tall?
Mm-hmm.
Is it very tall?
Mm-hmm.
Is it yellow in color?
Mm-hmm.
Does it have a long neck?
Mm-hmm.
Is it a giraffe?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Next fun game is bingo. Here again the player number of players can be more than 2. And material required is pen and paper. Here you have to make grids of squares for this game. This is a fun game which improves child's reading skills and make them talk aloud. You can also buy this game on Amazon. I'll put the link in the description box. Draw a square grid on a page and choose a theme. Write out some words using the theme. Example, beach. So you write the words swimming, sandcastles, water, sea, shells, dolphin, sunbeds, picnic, etc. Make an extra copy of the words, ensuring there are a few extra than the amount on the page. Cut them up into squares and put in a ball scrunched up. Take turns in pulling out a word and reading it out loud, then finding it on your page. The first person to find all the words call out bingo and is the winner. If you're traveling and you have no time to prepare the word grid, you can still play this game, but you do need pen and paper. This will make your traveling easier with kids. And who doesn't want that, right? What you need to do is write down all the words, the objects that you anticipate to see on the way. Make 2 to 3 list of those words depending upon the number of players. For example, a red van, a bike, a cycle, a bicycle, a restaurant. And each player has to cross off those words when they see out of the window. Whoever crosses off first calls out bingo and is the winner. Next game is rhyming game. In this game, again, more than 2 players are required and no material is required. You say a word and the next player has to say a rhyming word. This way, each player keeps on saying a rhyming word to the previous word. And whenever that stock ends, the next player says a new word. And this way the game continues. There is no winner or loser in this game, but this game improves child's linguistic skills. They learn to rhyme, they learn to come up with the rhyming words, and hence it improves the vocabulary. Light.
Might.
Kite.
Tight.
Right.
Fight.
Flight.
Sight.
Bite.
Very nice. Height. Okay, new word.
Go.
No.
Show.
Bow.
Throw.
Toe. For younger kids, we can make it a little easier. We can do it in a riddle form. For this, you have to do your homework first and then sit with kids. But how it has to be done, take a look. Okay.
It's basically a bird. And it starts with rhyming word row.
Crow.
Okay, one more. It's an animal and it rhymes with a mat.
Cat.
Okay, right.
Great.
Next game is eject the game. Again, more than 2 players required, no material required. In this game, one person think of any relative and that person describes it to the rest of the players. The other people have to guess who is that person. This improves child's vocabulary because they're learning how to describe people and they will never ever forget those words because they're associating it with the people whom they know very, very well.
He is chubby.
Okay.
He is plump.
Okay.
He is cute.
Is it a boy?
Yes.
Is it a child?
Yes.
Okay, more? Say more about him. How about his hair?
His hair is curly.
About his nature?
He's cute and he listens to everyone.
Okay.
All the time talks with me but never talks with you.
Okay, it's Shirley Nikki. Next game is guess the noun. Number of players 2 or more, material required, nothing. Make 4 columns, name, place, animal, thing on your paper. Say a letter. Participant has to write words starting from that letter in each category. Whoever will write maximum correct will be the winner. Now let's talk about certain board games which are very good word games. Number 1 is Scrabble. Number of players required 2 or more. This game is very good for kids age 7 plus. But you can also play the alteration of this game for any age group of children. What we do is we just lay all the letters there and we put a timer, say 5 minutes. And within 5 minutes, 2 players have to make maximum words from those letters. Whoever makes maximum words is the winner. See how we did. Word games like Boggle and Othello. I will provide the links of these games in the description box. You can buy from there. Besides these board games, there are certain books like Word Search and Crossword Puzzles. These books can be done by the child individually, or you can do it as a team, or if there are 2 kids, then you can buy identical books and let the child compete if they love to compete. So the links of such books are also there in the description box, or you can buy from the store nearby. It's a series on how to keep kids busy when they are home. So do watch this playlist, which will help you to get more ideas. And also share with other parents whom you think it is going to help. Bye-bye.